This is probably the first time in the history of mankind that we see a lot of young guys who have trouble getting it up. Now, this used to be something that just old people got. Because, you know, if you get old, your body starts to deteriorate and things just start working less. That makes sense. But right now, there is something so fundamentally wrong in our modern lifestyle that we actually see more and more young guys who have erection problems. And even among the guys that can still get it up, a lot of guys don't really get to like 100% strength, if you know what I mean. But it's more like an 80, 90% of what it could have been. Which means that it is a slightly softer, floppier, but also smaller version of what it could have been. And so in this video, I wanted to go over three factors that are probably three of the most important factors that are causing these erection problems among young guys. So if you are someone that sometimes struggles, and this doesn't necessarily mean that you have full-blown erectile dysfunction and you never get it up, but you know, if you are someone that sometimes struggles to get it up, or maybe you lose it over time as the session progresses, or you know, you recognize what I said with the 100% strength thing. You think, well, you know, this is not 100%. You know, it could be a little harder and a little bigger. Then these are some things that might actually work for you. Number one is porn. You need to quit watching porn. Now, for those people that are regular viewers of my channel, you probably know all about it. I've talked about this before plenty of times. But porn messes you up mentally. It messes up your sexuality. It kind of works like a drug. You start to need more and more of it. You start to need more stimuli, and you start to need more perverse stimuli, or at least more specific stimuli. When you watch porn, you can constantly click to the next video. So as soon as you're bored for like 1 second, you skip to the next part. Within the video, you click to another video, you click to a more perverse video, you look for another camera angle, etc., etc. And so you condition yourself to become used to getting more and more stimuli all the time. And so when you actually end up with a real person, it turns out that the real thing doesn't really excite you anymore. And so you can't get it up at all because you're used to like more perverse categories, and the real thing is not that perverse as you're used to. Or you get it up and you get going, but then you lose it over time because, you know, you've been conditioned to constantly skip to the next video, and when you're there with a real person, you can't just snip your fingers and then magically conjure a new person in front of you or anything. The real thing doesn't work like that. And so that's why we see so many guys who either can't get it up, or they lose it over time, or they don't really get to that 100% strength, because they've messed up their brain by watching too much porn. Porn is without a doubt one of the biggest, if not the biggest factor causing erection problems in young guys today. There's no way around it. It is not easy, but you are going to have to quit watching porn, or at least watch it significantly less. Number two is exercise. Our ability to get it up has to do with blood flow. It is literally because of blood flowing in and out of there. Now, our modern lifestyles are starting to become more and more sedentary. The average person doesn't move a whole lot. In the past, we used to do a lot of walking around because we were hunting and looking for berries and stuff. But now the average person just spends the day sitting on a chair. When we are at school, we sit on a chair. When we are at college, we sit in a chair. When we work a desk job, we sit in a chair. And then we're done with college or work. And then we come home. What do? We sit down on the couch to watch Netflix. Or we sit down on our chair in front of the computer. And we start playing games on the computer. And so the more sedentary that our lifestyle becomes, the less good our body actually becomes at pumping around that blood through our system, which is exactly what we need to get it up. And so what we need to do is get our body used to pumping around that blood again, which means pick up some weights, start doing some exercises, go for a run, do some cardio, do whatever. But you just need to make sure that you do some activity again. Now, cardio is probably going to help you the most because, well, they don't call it cardio for no reason. Cardio is the best way to train your cardiovascular system. Now, I would actually recommend going for a run. I mean, sure, if you like swimming, then you can go swimming if you want. But the thing about running is that it's easier to do. See, if you like swimming, then you always need to go to the swimming pool. Running is just more practical. Because even if you hate running, and even if you don't have a lot of time, you can just put on a pair of running shoes, step outside of the front door, and run a block around the house, and you've at least done something. You see, it doesn't even have to be long. It's not like you need to run for like an hour a day. If you're not used to running at all, then just go for like a 5-minute run every other day, and that will already be a great start. It will be so much better than doing nothing. You need to make sure that you get some form of physical activity. So number three is to be present in the current moment. Now, what I mean by this is one of the biggest problems why we can't get it up is just a straight up mental thing. It's because we worry. A lot of the time we worry about having to get it up. And ironically, because we worry about it, it actually becomes harder to get it up. We get in this like vicious circle where just things keep getting worse. And so the best way to break this pattern is to stop worrying about it. Now, this is easier said than done, but here's how to actually do it. Be present in the current moment. Now, they also call this concept mindfulness. You might have heard about this before in like a spiritual context, like meditation and mindfulness meditation. But guys, the concept of mindfulness works wonders. It basically means focus on what you're actually doing. So don't think about the past, don't think about the future, don't think about other things, but actually focus purely on what you are doing there in that very moment. So for example, when you're getting things on with the girl, you know, and you're starting to touch each other, you're starting to kiss, this is the point where a lot of guys might start worrying, and they start thinking, oh my God, you know, I'm about to have sex, I'm about to actually do it. This means that I have to get an erection soon. Uh-oh, I'm not sure if I can get an erection. I sure hope that I can get it up. And because you're worrying about it, you know, you're not focused in the moment anymore, and that's actually where things go wrong. So instead of thinking this is the point where I'm about to do it, just don't think about that at all, but focus purely on the moment. Just focus purely on the fact that you are kissing a girl. Focus on the sensation. Focus on how her body feels when you're touching her. Focus on how the kissing feels. Don't think about anything else. Just focus purely on the moment. Because when you are purely focused in the moment, first of all, you're not worrying, which is a huge thing, but also you allow nature to do its thing. And when you're not worrying and you let nature do its thing, that is probably where things actually start to get up. Now, this might take a little bit of practice. It might not instantly work the first way around, but it definitely is the way to counter this problem. You can also practice this in other areas of your life, the concept of mindfulness. It's not like you can only do this when you're getting things on with a girl. You can practice it with anything. So I would highly recommend you just start practicing whatever you do. Like you drink a cup of tea, you focus on you drinking the cup of tea. You focus on the temperature of the tea, the taste of the tea. When you're doing the dishes, don't think about what you've done today. Don't think about what you're going to do tomorrow. But think about how you are doing the dishes. Start practicing the concept of mindfulness. To a lot of people, this might sound a little bit spiritual, a little bit far-fetched. But guys, I promise you, this is like a mental skill that is going to help you out so much in life, including your sex life and your ability to get it up. So I hope that these tips are going to help you guys out. I'm pretty sure that they can have big effects for a lot of people, because these are definitely three of the biggest factors that are causing these problems in young men today. So guys, good luck. If you liked the video, click the like button, maybe click the subscribe button if you want to see more videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.